Hey, sportsman, John Bergsman here from the Great Lakes Insider Fishing Report. We're joined again today by Tom Ball, owner of Wilderness Treasures, way up in Pickford, Michigan, right on the shores of Manuskong Bay and the lower St. Mary's River. Tom, I've heard that the ice fishing early season has really kicked off with a bang.
Yes, we've probably got as good a fishing or the best fishing we've had here probably close to 20 years.
Oh.
They're good ice. Guys are getting tons of walleyes, a lot of throwbacks, but a lot of big monsters too.
Yeah, exactly. And I've been seeing pictures on Facebook from just regular fishermen, and they have all been clamoring. You know, and Tom, what we're experiencing downstate, as you well know, is just really a lack of safe ice. And I think it is driving many, many people to make that cross the bridge and up to Manuskong and also out to the west. But talk to me a little bit. What are the presentations? What are most guys coming into the Wilderness Treasure store right there in the corner and buying up from you that's been working well for the walleye?
Well, you know, like you said, well, we got guys coming in from all over the Midwest, Ohio, Indiana, guys from Saginaw Bay, Badenoch. I've gotten guys from North Carolina. If anyone's trying to fish, they're flocking up here. The best thing I can suggest to people is moving around until you find the school of fish. Of course, Manuskong Bay is notorious for just being a big flat mud bottom, so you gotta run around and find them. But it seems like the majority of the people who are jigging are doing really well with spoons,
okay.
Single hook spoons. And when they're jigging, they always have one or two, because you can use three lines, of course. They're putting set lines out. And I think the jigging action in Manuskong Bay, where it's muddy and hard to see, is bringing the fish in, and they're just nailing the set lines. And they're using just small Northland forage minnows. They're just using single treble hooks with a bead on them. Anything small, it just seems. But the jigging, I think, is the key, because that's bringing them close to those other baits.
Exactly. You know, that is a very, very, what you just described, that is a walleye 101 for an ice fisherman, is to use one of your lines as an attractor and to have what you call a set line, or I refer to as a dead stick, very close by. I'm talking, you know, a foot, 2 foot, 3 feet away, and they'll seem to come in and take a good look and be attracted by that jigging action, but then they'll turn to that little minnow that might be just slowly struggling against the weight of the jig in a real natural fashion. And if you're just patient, that fish will engulf that, and you'll have a nice walleye in your hands. Now, you guys have got...
Yep, exactly.
Now, we've got great perch fishing in Manuskong as well, and whether it goes one day or the next is always tough to say, as you know. But for perch anglers that want to come up and maybe try for a mixed bag of walleye and perch by setting some tip-ups out, what's your advice to the perch angler? How close... One of the biggest questions, Tom, I need you to answer is, I've had this asked to me a lot. How close to the bottom, if you're setting a small minnow that you guys at Wilderness Treasure are famous for, of having both size baits, you know, perch minnows, walleye minnows, and all the things people need, when they're setting up to try to tip up fish for perch, how far off the bottom should that minnow be?
You know, we've had a lot of discussion around the bait shop this year, and I have one of my buddies brought in a 9, 10, 11-pound walleye, and we have them up on the wall. And, you know, you look at them, and they're wondering, you know, it seems like, you know, what do I got to do to jig these walleyes in or to bring the walleyes or perch in? And the walleye's eyes are on top. So we have a tendency to jig too close to the bottom for
mm-hmm.
walleyes.
Mm-hmm.
And the guys who are using jigging wraps and ripping wraps, they give it a big jig, and it goes really high up in the water level, and then it comes down. Well, that attracts the walleye in. When we're going for perch, usually we're 6 inches off the bottom, 4 inches off the bottom, because the perch's eyes, if you look at them, are right on the side. They can see laterally pretty easily, and they seem to school right on the bottom. Where the walleyes, a lot of times, you know, if they're 6 inches off the bottom and you're jigging on the bottom, they're going to go right by it. They might not even see it.
Exactly.
So we've been really having good luck with the guys who are ripping the jig instead of just jigging it a little bit like you would a crappie or a bluegill. The guys who are giving a big pull up, getting all that flash going high up in the water column, and then as it settles down, boom, they hit it when it hits the bottom.
Exactly.
But the perch seem to be right on the bottom.
You know, and if you notice, If you notice, Tom, what you're saying is absolutely right, because if you watch any video at all about underwater perch that are feeding, they're feeding nose down. They're actually like poking their nose into the bottom. They're picking things up off the bottom. You know, they'll hit a minnow, of course, suspended. But when they're just naturally looking for food, they've almost got on a downward 45-degree angle, and they're poking and picking at the bottom. They're looking for larvae coming out of the mud. So to be extremely close to the bottom is a great tip. And also being a foot off the bottom, if you're going to set a minnow for a tip-up is what you're saying, Tom, being 12, 16 inches off the bottom is by no means too far away from the bottom, correct?
Right, correct.
Yeah.
You know, up on Manaskan Bay, we're lucky. We have a large number of perch. The guys who are going out and getting 5, 6 walleye or bringing in 6, 8, 10, you know, 10-plus inch perch with them. So, you know, the guys who are willing to try something a little new, keep one high, keep one low, jig a little different, those are the guys that are really, really bringing in the fish. And it's funny because the guys who think they know what they're doing out there, kind of like Dane Stanaway up at All-Star, you know, we're so used to doing it the way we've been doing it for 15 years. And with the high water, things have changed. And those guys, they go out, not Dane, of course,
it was a joke. We all love Dane.
It's the guys who don't know how to fish or don't fish much are going out and just bringing in huge numbers of fish because they're doing things that are different.
Exactly. You know, and if you want a great weekend, like Tom mentioned, come on up to the Pickford area, Manuskong Bay, all the way up to the Sioux. But I don't think there's much really good ice up towards the Sioux. You're really going to want to concentrate your efforts in and around the Manuskong Bay to Drummond Island areas. And that's going to give you great opportunity to catch a lot of walleye, a lot of perch. Stop in at Tom's place. That's Wilderness Treasures. It's right downtown Pickford. On 29, right there where you'd turn to head into the Manuskong Bay landing and access area. Tom's got all of the right baits, all of the right stuff that's specific to that region, and that's important. You can show up with all your own tackle, which is fine to do, but it's worth a stop because he's going to have the best bait and he's going to have great information. Tom Ball, thanks so much for another great fishing report, and we will be chatting with you again in a couple of weeks.
You bet, John. Thanks for all the hard work you do and getting our place on the map out there, because we're catching fish and we want everybody to come up and enjoy that too.
You bet. Thanks. Have a great day, Tom.
You too, John. Thanks. Bye.